Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. It's cure for sickness, protection against calamities, brings about sustenance, results in much blessings, barakah, defends against 70 types of misfortunes, such as insanity, and it's highly emphasized in Islam and practiced by God's chosen representatives. Yes, indeed, it's sadaqa, or giving charity, and it's mentioned in more than 50 places in the Holy Quran. It's a beautiful deed that even science tells us today that it will enhance happiness. Indeed, most of us know that sadaqa is a virtuous act, but there are some important jurisprudential as well as spiritual considerations we need to be aware of. Here, I will discuss 10 as part of the charitable act of giving money, since doing anything righteous for the sake of God is also considered sadaqah, such as, for example, smiling. Number one, sadaqah is defined as ihsan, kindness, by giving money with the intention of seeking the pleasure of God. So, the niyyah, intention, is very important. That is why scholars say when we give sadaqah, we should give it with the general intention of qurbatan ila Allah, rather than for a specific purpose, such as seeking protection. The latter is fine, except that we may lose out on the benefits of sadaqah in general. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, chapter 9, verse 103, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَحِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا. Take from the wealth that which cleanses and purifies them. Number two, the mustahab sadaqah can be given to anyone, i.e. there's no restriction of faith or denomination or background. However, the wajib sadaqah, like zakatul fitra or the kaffarat, for example, must be given to believers only. Number three, if you're a sayyid, you can give all forms of sadaqah, i.e. the wajib and recommended, to a sayyid or a non-sayyid. So for example, zakatul fitra or normal zakat can be given by a Hashimi sayyid to another sayyid. However, a non-sayyid cannot give the wajib sadaqah like the zakat to a sayyid. But a non-sayyid can give mustahab sadaqah, like the one we put aside in a box at home, for example, to a sayyid. And this is important. There is a small condition though, and that is it should not be belittling or one that causes humiliation to the sayyid. Therefore, a non-sayyid can give the mustahab sadaqah to a sayyid. Number four, it is better to give sadaqah in private rather than giving it in public. Giving it in private is actually more rewarding. The exception is if by doing so in public, we have the intention of encouraging others to gain reward as well as participate. Number five, what about putting the money inside those charity boxes? Is that sadaqah? And can you, for example, take some money out of the box temporarily or sometimes put notes instead of the coins? Well, scholars have differed on this issue. Ayatullah Khoury, rahmatullahi alayhi, for example, says, the moment you make the intention for sadaqah and put money aside, you can't then touch it or change it. Ayatullah Sistani, hafidhahullah, however, says that until the money reaches the poor or the needy or the intended usage, you can take it out of the box or exchange the coins for notes, for example. The exception, however, is boxes from Al-Ain charity, which have been designated by His Eminence as actual receiving of the needy when you place the money inside the box. Six, it is more rewarding to give sadaqah to blood relatives, arham, rather than others. Hence, if you have a relative who is needy, try to fulfill their needs and give them first. Actually, there are interesting narrations from the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam that says, if you have a relative who's upset with you, for example, and they're not needy, you should give them sadaqah to make them happy, even if there are others who are not relatives who would need this donation. This is because sadaqah can also be given to a person who is not needy. But of course, giving it to a poor person is much more rewarding. Number seven, when you give sadaqah to someone, you don't need to tell them it's sadaqah. Sometimes that helps for the person to accept the money. Eight, it's makruh, disliked, for us to reject someone who's come to ask us for help. even if we know they may not be entitled or may not be poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant reward, since if we do it for His sake, the act of sadaqah is blessed and rewarding. Number 9, once you give someone sadaqah, you can't take it back or ask for it back. And number 10, there are some adab, etiquettes when giving sadaqah. This includes not expecting thanks from the person, not making false promises to people who ask, not taking advantage of the poor and the vulnerable, to give what we desire the most, not to rebuke or say inappropriate words to people who ask, and to kiss one's own hands after giving sadaqah, not the person that we are actually given and that person's hands. This was the practice of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, according to a narration. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all your deeds.